Ah yes, MelonDS, a cool up-and-coming Nintendo DS emulator that has shown huge potential. But, notice anything wrong here? Huh! Like, you can't go full screen. You can't, you just can't, like... Why can't you go full screen? I mean, just look at these gigantic bars that are ugly and stupid and ugly and stupid. And let's just say that because of these bars, my gaming is, not at peak performance. But since I don't take no for an answer, I had to step in and hacky-bakey something. They said it was impossible. They said it could be not done. They said I should go and find a job. That's right, Fullscreen is here to save the day. I mean, just look at Yoshi here walking and bang, just like that. Yoshi, is still walking, but it's Fullscreen, so yeah. That's pretty cool, right? I can't top that, right? I mean, I can do something good in my life every once in a while, right? Well, it's all wrong. Allow me to introduce custom hotkeys. If I just want to glance at the map, I have to dig in the menus, go to config, then screen sizing, and then emphasize bottom. And then repeat that to get big Yoshi again. But what if you could do all that with just one click? Well, excuse me, now you can.
Nice.
Need a hotkey to switch the screen size? I got ya, fam. Want a hotkey for opening a new game? Sure, why not? Oh wait, you are the hotkey to rotate the screen. Why didn't you say so? Or maybe, fancy a hotkey for switching between software and hardware renderer. Maybe, just, you know, no? What can I say except you're welcome. Here at Channel Name, our priority is to do the impossible. Best of all, you can change or create your own hotkey.
Wow!
Okay, that's enough showing off. About time you start the tutorial, guys. First, how to make MelonDS go full screen. Okay, so first, download Windows Borderless Gaming, then launch MelonDS, and then after that, launch Windows Borderless Gaming. After you launch it, a new icon will pop up in the taskbar. Right click it and choose Add Window. Click on the MelonDS window and press F3. A box will appear, so click Yes. But blimey! The taskbar is still there, what should we do? Oh no! I mean, you could stop roll and drop. But to fix that, right click the icon, hover over settings, and then click on game settings. From there, you need to input your screen resolution in these boxes. Also, it's better to remove title from identifier. Now click apply, and ta-da! However, if you have scaling other than 100%, Windows full screen will get confused and enlarge the screen way too much. To fix that, we are gonna change a scaling setting inside Windows Borderless Gaming. Now if Windows Borderless Gaming is open, relaunch it to see the changes. Now that MelonDS is full screen, let's get into the juicy part, shall we? The hotkeys. First, download and install AutoHotkey. AutoHotkey basically is a programming language that allows you to write scripts. After you install AutoHotkey, launch my script and voila! Okay, I don't know how to spell this word, guys. Could you help me? Type in the comment how you spell voila. But
hey, listen!
Maybe you want to change the hotkeys or even make your own. And here's how. Right-click the script and click edit. It will open in your default text editor. As you can see, there is a description of the script at the top. Now, let me explain the script for you. So, hashtag ifwhenactive means that the comments under it only execute if a specific window is open. So, I typed the name of the application of MelonDS because you don't want the hotkey to work in Chrome. Now, this is the key you want to use. So, type 1 to use the key 1 as a hotkey. So, you could type F in the chat, guys. When menu select item is a command that selects a menu or an option from a menu inside a program's window. AHK underscore exe MelonDS is the name of the MelonDS process. AHK needs to know which program to apply the command to, and this is how we tell it. Everything after the process name are the menu names. So we have config menu, inside it there is screen sizing, and inside that there is emphasize button. The return command means stop, so the PC stops executing commands. To change a hotkey, all you have to do is change the key behind the double colons. Now if you are more in the creative sides, you can create your own hotkeys. First, create the key you want to use. Then, copy code from any hotkeys I created. And now, all you have to do is input the name of the menu or item that you want to trigger with the hotkey. And just like that, the ultimate MelonDS experience is here. But why choose this emulator over this mummy? Well, there are two reasons. One, you can output 8 times the resolution with barely any frame drops, provided you have good hardware. And two, there are some games that work flawlessly on MelonDS but have graphical issues on this mummy, like Pokemon Ranger 2. And that's it, guys.